Good morning, guys. That's definitely a nice view. The phone on the new trim. Before I'm going to show you guys what's inside the box. This is my old feet rest. They called the dead feet rest. It's originally for the M3, but it will fit the non-M3 as well. Make notice that for the coupe and the convertible is different than the one for the sedan and the touring. Actually, this is not an old one. I bought it brand new because it's really an eye catcher. And those things I want new. Same as the roaster that I broke and I had to buy for $100. Like you can see here, there's a line in it. Maybe you can like get it off for the convertible. Same as with the mid console. I bought the gray one used. It's a guy who sold a lot of E46 parts. He sold it as new, but this was kind of a rip-off. You can see like a line in here. It didn't crack, but it bended. I had some gray kit left from the trim, so I made it a little bit stronger. Also, it was cut out here, and yeah, I don't think they did it get it out with care. So he said it was because of transport, but actually this was like a rip-off. I'm going to place this one. I still need clamps to mount the carpet. I'm not going to use the old ones. I have to order new ones, but I'm going to mount it because it's really irritating driving with my feet not on the dead feet rest. So that is the M feet rest. Then the box, what's in it? Oh yeah, remember the ring? I did some research. I don't know where it's for. Maybe to lock it. If you know it, please down in the comments and tell me. What I did notice is that the top is bending out, up or down, I don't know. I think it has to go up, so I'm going to remove the bolt and check if I did it right. Probably it's already bended, so it's fine. Then what's inside this box? Like a lot of stuff. Guys, I like the roller just like in the rear, but in a car you can definitely not miss a cup holder. So I'm going to remove the old one. Corona, you have to wear it here in the building markets as well. So I'm going to remove the old one. I already cleaned it, of course, and I'm going to click in the new one. The gray, you have like the non-M3 and the M3. I believe that the M3 is a little bit darker. The cup holder is in gray, in black, and in beige. And it's only one color of gray. So I bought this one. Then part number two. I was doubting if I have to order the rubber and the spring loose because it's separated on the building pictures. But I ordered it. I thought if they didn't supply it, I used my old one. But the spring is supplied and also the black rubber. I still have to mount this for my brake light. But I'm going to place this. Oh, I see this. You have to place the rear part first. I have to mount everything with screws anyway. And then you can click in the cup holder. Yes, that has to be second. So, it's in. Then I used some cheap foam for the rear of the fuse box. It's definitely a must because your wires can get cut. This is original BMW. Show you the part number. So I'm going to get it loose. I'm going to use the form that I already have and put some new BMW foam in it. It's really sticky. Sticker. Of course, new clamps for the trim. Oh yeah. The down trim, so the M trim of the steering wheel. I don't know if you see it, but I get really irritated when I twist the steering wheel and I have my camera over there. You can see two different kinds of bolts in it. On a real OEM, I see two bolts. And this one, so I bought two of each and I'm going to try to fit which torque supposed to be in. Then on the bottom, so where you tap your oil, I lost my cap, so I ordered this and this is the wrong one. I don't know, this is for the set 4 or something. I have to check if I gave the wrong part number or that it's wrong supplied. I'm going to check that later. Not that important. This is for the rear. These are also clamps for this cap that doesn't fit. Show the part numbers as well. A lot of guys lose that. Maybe the garage forgot to put it on. Okay guys, this is for the rear. Shit, they gave me the wrong. Okay, this is to mount your seat belt. This is the the tool. It's the part number. I'm already have this one, but it's all bended, so I just bought it new. And this is an important one. Inside your chassis, it's a little bit weird to put it in. You have these rubbers and they're all worn out. Show you the part number as well. So I'm going to place it in because it's behind the carpet and you have to do it before you click the rest of your trim in. The bolts are like really worn out. They are all rusted. They're like more than 20 bucks a piece. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use the old ones and then later I'm going to put new ones in. I can reach them anyway. Then this thing, so the upper part, so the part number again from your steering column. This is one thing that's also really inside, and what I noticed with BMW is some parts are like super cheap and when you buy them second hand they're asking the same price or even more. And sometimes they are extremely expensive, like trim on your doors, 500 or 600 a piece. So this is a part that wasn't so expensive, so I bought it new. And why? Because this thing, so the little round in it where you can push in your clamp, it was broken off. Tried to get it out of my old dashboard, but you cannot replace it, so you have to glue it. If this is not expensive, there are no scratches on it, then I'm going to replace it. I thought I had to let loose the clamps inside the dashboard, but that wasn't necessary. You can just click it in here and push the leather inside and it clamps on the dashboard. And you need only one clamp. And I think I also ordered it. I have to check if it's there or else I have my old one. And then the last thing, like I said, this is a cheap part, maybe 10, 20 or 30 bucks. Then on the other hand, the bottom part of your steering column is not mounted. So I'm going to use the old one, already cleaned it. It's like with your knee protector in it. This will cost a fortune. So I'm going to use my old one. It's it's still in a good state. The only thing that I'm going to do is there are two big clamps inside. Oh shit. So I bought those new, they're not so expensive. Show you the part number. And then this part is already done. So okay, what I'm going to do now, or what I'm going to do today, I'm going to check the ring. I have to take the bolt out. I don't have the clamps for the carpet yet, but I'm going to place my feet rest because I don't want the carpet to get dirty, so I'm driving my car without putting my feet on it, and it's really irritating driving. So I'm going to put it in, put the small glove box in, put the steering column in, and today I want my fuses to be done, so I'm going to do that as well. And I also need to cut the subwoofer. I don't think I have time for that today, and the trim above it. So enough to be done. So let's get started, guys. Before I forgot, this lock from your automatic has to be mounted like this. I had it all nice and tight there at the rear, and it didn't get out of park, so I had a fault code because my car had a cold start and it was staying locked on park, so I got late at work. So I had to mount it like this. If you have to do it manual, you have to push in this button, but just put it like here. I don't know if there needs to be a clamp in here, but the steering wheel column coming on, so it should be fine, but leave it like this. Attention to detail: gray cable tool and gray tie ribs. Okay, this is like super hard to get in. Get the rubber in first, put some weight at 40 on here, and then try to twist it in. So I asked around, and nobody really knows for sure where these wires on the center blocks are for. When I look at fuse number 47, I see a thick red black cable. You can't really see it, I think, but it's not going there, so I'm going to take the power for these 2x12 volts, not from the center block, but the same as this one. Like I said a few times, do as much work at the car while everything is out. You have a 100 ampere fuse, and you have this one. I looked up for the number, and that's a 50 amp. So if you decide to put the 12 volts on this one, so after the fuse, then use the first one or this one with the 100 amp in it. So this is what I made out of it. It's like semi half OEM. Going to push them in there, and then we're finally done with the fuse box. It was nice to do sometimes, but they're really, really done with it. So click it in and then put the lock back on. So then for the documentation, because I'm not going to put the fuses in, so on slot number 18 and 19, the empty ones, 2x12 volt, and when I get the unit in, I'm going to put these in and it's working. And if there's something wrong, I know it's this and not something else. So I'm going to say this really slowly. Watch out, you don't have any bolts falling in. I have one down there, so I have to get it out. When it's a ring, you can wrinkle the fuse box and it falls out here. But this thing is too big. So when you want to get your clips out, please don't start pulling at the plastic. Just slide them to the side and then get them off like this, so you don't break your trim, because the clear coat can burst pretty quickly. So if you want to get your clamps out, do it like this, and then afterwards slide them back in. And okay, it's out. I hope you're happy now. The Myrtle wood costed me like over a grand, and probably you guys say, oh, I know what trim that is, that's piano black. But no, it isn't. I'll show you later, but it's like with flake in it, and it's called BMW Cosmos Black. So it was from an M3. I went there and I thought, yeah, okay, maybe it's like a repainted or resprayed Titan set. But I came in the garage, it was all white garage with Ferrari there, who was loading his battery, and this trimmer was in front, and he got it out of his old M3. He got a new one, and also three Porsches. So it was definitely a not resprayed one. It's really a Teton black. It's like a little bit like individual. And yeah, of course it's nice. It looks like a bit like candy. Okay, it matches the armrest really nice. Of course, it belongs together. I had it sprayed by a friend of mine. That is water, in case you were asking. With new paint and also scratch resistant clear coat on it. So it's not really mounted yet. I have to get the head unit out and doing the wiring. Then I have to get the air fans loose again. I'm not going to break them again. And I'm going to make everything nice there. Put it in and then put the clamps in. And then we go into mount this Cosmos black interior. And like maybe you've seen it, I bought this one new, $175. Oh no, $157. And also this one new, and I sprayed it. They do that at the next model, the E90. So I saw it at the dad of my best friend's convertible, the 335i, and I've got it from there. So it matches nice, paint stays on because it was new, and this is how it's going to look. And rear panels supposed to look like that as well. So talk to you guys later. This is how it's supposed to look. Some people really have a mess over here and they like squeeze it in. So I'm going to keep it like this. It's good enough. I'm going to save up for a new head unit anyway. So I'm going to get this one loose and put this one in. Put the clamps in there and then finally the Cosmos trim. One more thing, now we're down here. The trigger wire for your amplifier, so your remote cable. There is some heat in it, so I was busy with it anyway. So I got it there to the fuse box and back and then to the rear. So remember the cups? Dash. We need that one, don't forget it. So for now, I left it at the front. Looks nice, doesn't it? Use some longer screws, and I keep my $100 fan new. I'm not going to crack it. Maybe when I have a new head unit and never going to get it out again, I'm going to try to get this loose. But for now, I'm doing it like this. For the other thing, don't forget this screw. It's mounted into the painted frame, and we put a clamp in there, so it's an extra screw that you can use. To center the dashboard a little bit and to tighten it up, and do these kind of things before you put your trim on. And of course some new clamps. 9 out of 10 times when you get your trim off, they break off. I see some guys doing it really careful, and then maybe one or two will break. The thing is, they will fall off inside your dashboard, and you can hear it rankling when you drive on a bumpy road. So I always try to get them out really careful, or to renew them and get them out careful so they don't fall inside your dashboard. And what have we here? A split nail. That's for our new top of the steering wheel column. So I'm going to put them in now and then finally put the trim on, and then later the dashboard, and then later the light under the dashboard. So we're at the garage to get this, I believe they call it a paraffin plate for the rear seats. As you can see, it's modified for the subwoofer.
So I'm going to use this SML for the new paraffin plate. I used the old insert. It's a pretty good fitment, but I'm going to modify it first and then I'm going to cut the new one. Okay guys, we're going to trial fit it. I'm going to adjust it maybe one more time. It has to be a good fitment, don't have to be perfect. Really something from BMW, you get this in like purse and foam and whatever, and you don't get the stickers supplied, you have to order them separately. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to fit them and I'm going to use two clamps to center the insert. I'm not going to push them in yet. I'm going to show you the part number. So, let's fit it. So there was already an opening, but I had to make it a little bit bigger. Going to make the final adjustments and then we're done. I need this cap. I don't know yet if I am going to need to screw it in from the inside, so I don't know if I can mount the back panel already with the pins. So I'm going to check that out, and I'm also going to do something with the Harman Kardon tweeters. So I need to do the cabling nice as possible before I'm going to mount everything. But I'm going to adjust this, and I'm also going to kit the subwoofer, the ski hatches out. So that's it for today. Tomorrow my son is his birthday, so I have to hurry up again. So I'm going to do these adjustments and then I'm come back to you guys later. I just noticed I have a black version and also a gray one, and the quality is like so much better than this cheap knockoff one. It's really BMW quality sticker is way better. This hangs loose and this is really tight. So I'm going to measure it up and then I'm done here. Length of the foam, I did it in 3 pieces. You can also do it in 2 pieces. But the end result looks pretty nice. I'm happy with it. The wires are protected and we're done down here.
So LJ got a cookie from the seller of the car part shop. So he's going to crumble the new interior over. So I have to vacuum clean it again. Fast one, cleaner, conditioner and protector. Only use cleaner, like the aggressive one, when your interior is very, very dirty. What I always do is step one, green soap, just navel it up. Then I use the combination of cleaner and conditioner. I use that as a cleaner, so it's less aggressive. And then conditioner, I use as a conditioner, and then sometimes protector. If I may choose out of the 4 steps, which one is the most important, then definitely the conditioner. And it's the same like with your hair. If you use shampoo, then all the supplements are getting out of the leather. Then you have to put it back with conditioner. So I'm definitely going for the conditioner. If you do it like 3 times a month, cleaning your leather, then use the cleaner and the conditioner 1 time and 2 times the conditioner. I've got gray leather, so I would see the dirt more often. So I have to use the cleaner, so I'm going to use the combination. This is 3-in-1, cleaner, conditioner and protectant. Okay, well, I'm going to put it away and we're going to get some wipes to treat the leather. So talk to you guys later. Deze?
Ja, deze ook
leuk. En die?
Stoppen.
Deze ook?
Deze.
Oh, goed zo. Ja. Kom.